Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to share with you how I've been repurposing the blank pages in my Hobonichi Cousin. I've been trying out different layouts before I use it in my HON Cousin size A5. Now the difference between the HON and the Cousin is, well, the HON is called that because it has a hardcover. This one happens to have a cover on cover on it because it's the bow tie fabric. These two are basically the same. And again, the only difference is this one has a hardcover, this one doesn't. This one will be my catch-all if you watched my video into this particular cover. And so I pulled out this one. So this one I purchased in 2019. I used it as my doodling, drawing, Hobonichi challenge journal. This is going to be used as my writer's notebook journal so I can keep track of my word count, my thoughts, ideas for a story that I'm currently writing right now. And it's going to be dedicated and in one book. I plan to use the HB90 system in here. I'm going to change it a little bit to make it fit into my Cousin. I will link Breathings as well as Sarra Cannon. She's the one that created HB90, her class as well as her planner. I will link that down below. If you have goals that you want to accomplish, she helps you break down your goals into doable projects, into tasks that you obviously need to follow through to try to accomplish whatever you want to accomplish in your life. And so in my case, I would like to try to self-publish a book. Taking her class has helped me realize how to do that by breaking it down into doable steps. So now let me go back to this. So she has her own planner. Again, I wanted it in one book, one location, because I just have too many planners. So again, when I bought this in 2019, Hobonichi Challenge, I wrote down all the prompts in the months. So now let's go to the first day. So this is how I was using it. Drawing down the prompt. So in this case, it was Mario. I also drew Luigi, Wario, and Waluigi. Is that how you say his name? I love this guy. But you can see how I was drawing. First in pencil, then in pen or a no-bleed black marker. That's supposed to be Captain Kirk with tribbles. And so I did this for a little while and then I kind of fell out and stopped doing it. As you see here. And then in July, I picked it back up. They were food prompts. And when I have food prompts, I like to do recipes. And so that's what I did. And now that I look back on it 3 years later, I think the drawings came out pretty nice. Didn't put down the recipes, started to fall off the bandwagon on doing this. And then I set it aside again and put it away in a box. Decided around November 24 that this would be my 2023, where I would try out different writing layouts that I would eventually transfer into here. Now, in addition to the HB90 planner, where I got some of the ideas, there's also Suzie O'Connell's 100-Day Writing Challenge workbook. I will list her workbook down below, as well as her Facebook group. I decided to try out this layout. So this is a little bit similar to what Suzie O'Connell uses in her planner, as well as Sarra Cannon's HB90 planner. I don't use all the prompts that they have in their planner, and so I sort of took out from their planners, put down in my planner what I do use. So here is the date. At the time I was trying to do task blocks, which Sarra Cannon teaches, except I can't click with it. It just doesn't work for me. So over here is my word count. So this would be my start word count and end word count. Total words written, the page that I started writing, and the page that I stopped. over here is my word count checks. So here's 250, 500, and they're in 250 word increments. I would check them off depending on what numbers I hit. I would write today's scene that I would be working on, what happens in that scene, and then at the end of my writing session, if I had any thoughts, comments, or distractions, I would put here. So I sort of like what I was doing there. So let me show you a blank one, because I've been using this. Okay, so let me show you this one. So this is how I started to use it, which is similar to what you saw in my cousin that I back of my daily journal. And I was doing it like this, was enjoying it, but then I wanted a little bit of color. And so what I did, let me try to find another blank one. You know what, let me show you the back. So this was what I started to do. So this is the first today. I decided to go ahead and keep basically the same thing, except this time I used a highlighter and I colored in the different areas. I didn't really want to use stickers, washi tape, because it will bulk up my planner, and that's not what I want to do for the hun. I do want some color in it, and the pastel highlighters that I found at Daiso worked perfectly. So I'm really, really happy with this. On the monthly page, I am going to probably break it down. So again, she teaches you your goal, how to break it down to a project, and then to your task. And in my case for December, I've been thinking about giving myself a weekly deadline with the tasks that I want to complete. And so this is how I may lay it out. And then this is the November review, which I haven't filled out yet, which is another reason why I'm filming today, because I do want to fill this out. And so for the month of November, I wrote 946 words, which is, I think, pretty good, considering that, you know, my mom has been on my mind and I haven't been able to get much done. I'm happy with the 946 words. So again, here you can see, so the days that I didn't do anything, I was either working on my story, not in here, or working out, trying to figure out the layout that I wanted to use, and then how I plan on getting things accomplished in 2024 with writing my story. And then on Sundays, Sarra has questions that she wants you to ask yourself. And so I wrote them down here, but since I don't always answer them, I'm not too sure if I'm gonna answer all five or if I'm gonna change the questions for myself of how I done this past week. And then on Monday we had street cleaning, so there's that. But going back to this one, so this is for an A5 piece of paper that I cut a little bit off the side and on the top and bottom, and then I taped it in with invisible tape. So I gave myself an extra sheet, and I'm pretty happy with that, and I'm pretty sure I will be doing this in here. And the last thing I wanted to show you was the weekly layout. So here is 2023. Now, this I always have with me because I work part-time for my husband. So when I'm not doing anything for him, I am writing. And so I've been doing my daily task on the given day. And so this is really similar to what I do in my, let me find one that's similar to my cousin, right? If you've watched my video, so it looks really similar to this. And though I'm really happy with this, pulling out the stickers takes a lot of time. And as much as I enjoy looking at this, I don't want to do this. I have this beside me all the time as I'm writing, so I would rather just write down what I need to get done for that day, check it off as I go, and then when it comes time for me to journal in here, I can pull this guy out, and then at that point have my stickers out, fill this out looking at this, and then make this one pretty and this one just more functional. And that's what I've been happily doing in here. So the mail is over here, and so that's what I've been doing. Then I wanted a little bit of color without putting down the stickers, so I went back to the highlighters. and just highlighted it. Really happy with the color. Now on this day, this week, I got stamps through the mail. And this one is Things to Do, so I wanted to try that out to see if I liked it. As you can see, there's no color. I can always go in with watercolor or maybe like a pencil, color pencils, and color it in. But, and this is where we are today. Again, more highlighters, black ink, highlighting the words, and then the tasks that I need to get done. So I've been really happy with this. I'm looking forward to transferring what I've done here, as well as the writing layouts that I just shared. So let me show you that again. Like this, into here. It should be a really good experience, and I should be able to keep this HON thin like this. So next year when I show this to you, 12 months from now, 11 months from now, it's gonna hopefully stay like this. That's the plan, at least. So that is a look of how I've reused or repurposed my Hobonichi Cousin with the ideas that I plan to transfer into the HON in 2024 as my writer's notebook. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos generally of my Hobonichi Cousin. That's it. Have a good weekend. Bye.